Hello everyone. Today we are explaining our new product that we have recently launched. It's called Toki 10 TMS. This is our PCB thermal analyzer, and as you can see, the hardware quality is very supreme in this. They provide a camera here, which is basically a thermal camera, and it can measure the temperature ranging from minus 10 degrees to 120 degrees Celsius. Then we have this stand here. This can be mounted here, or you can see we have a spot over here. They have given two screws with this. You can even change the position and mount the stand over here as per your requirement. Here they have given a working area, which is basically a rubberized area. Again, a very high quality area, and then we come here. We can change the working distance by using this mount. You can increase or decrease the height like this. At the same time, you can also change the angle of the camera like this, and you can use this to also increase or decrease the length of the stem. At the same, you can change the focus of the camera by rotating this lens, and additionally, the focus can also be changed. The fine focus can be changed using this. Now, with this, since this is a modern equipment, they have provided us with a USB that will be connected to your laptop, and you can hence analyze the PCB on the software on the laptop. But the fun thing about this is they have given us the USB to USB-C wire, so this ensures that the data transmission is very high. So the speed of the data transmission is very high. Now with this, you also will be provided with a software on your laptop, which can be run on your Windows laptop or Windows PC. You can also mount an additional accessory, which you have to buy from us if you want to increase this work distance even more. Like, you obviously have a maximum height over here, but for example, if you want to increase this height even more, you can use a tripod that can be mounted on this itself. Then the working distance would be increased. So that is an additional accessory. Now, this is very useful, especially if you want to see the electrical pause, or if you want to see the leakage current, or if you want to observe whether the driver is working properly or not, and observe the crystal oscillator. And we will explain about the software in the next video. Thank you. So now to explain you about the software over here, what we are using is basically a power supply of our screwdriver, which would be the PCB of which would be obviously heated whenever we will use the screwdriver. So we will be using the screwdriver, and the PCB will be heated, and we will show you the changes on the software. As I told you, we are using a power supply of a screwdriver here to show you how the color changes occur when the PCB is heated. So I'm running the screwdriver now, and you will be able to see some color changes. As you can see here, the PCB is more heated now. After running the power supply, you can see the orangish color here. That means the PCB is more heated over here, and this is white. That means it's even more heated. Now, how to locate the temperature? Here is a bar over here, and it shows you the maximum temperature, which is around 58 degrees Celsius right now, and the minimum temperature, which is 23.2 degrees Celsius right now. And the color it shows with the temperature. Like black one is the lowest and white one is the highest, and this is the IC basically, so it's more heated. So it's, as you can see, whenever I point my cursor at any area, it shows the temperature of that area. You can see that at various places. So further, you can also set the range of the temperature that you want to view. For example, I am decreasing the lower limit to, let's say, 49, or maybe let's just take it to 45, and the lowest will be 23. So whatever region is above 45, it will show in the white, and the other areas are shown in other colors. I can also increase the lower limit. For example, the lower limit would be 30 degrees approximately, and now you can see the black areas. So whatever colors you are seeing is above this lower limit, 30.2 degrees. So you can just view all the ranges according to this. Now one by one I'll be telling you about the features. You can take pictures using this function. Whenever you click, it will save the picture. You can screen record, and the video will be saved in the folder that you can set in the settings. I will come back to that later. Now this is temperature measurement. You can select various spots. This is a point, for example. I can take this point. I want to take this point, this point. So it will show you the average temperature around this point. Similarly, you can also use, you can also take a rectangle or a square. So it will show you the average temperature. For this to show the average temperature in a shape, you have to select this high temperature tracing. So with this one point you will get for the highest temperature on your picture, and the other points you will get inside the shapes. You can also take a polygon. So like this, you click and then you click again. For example, and when you are done, you double click and it will take a polygon, and here you can also see the average temperature of this polygon. So at a time, you can take up to 5 points, 5 spots. And 3 other shapes, which includes rectangle, polygon, and line. So up to 3 other shapes and up to 5 spots. And then you have this another feature called high temperature alarm. You can select it. As soon as you click here, the alarm function gets activated. And whatever the range you type here, if the temperature goes above that range, the alarm starts beeping, and you can turn it off by clicking here again. For editing this, you just have to type here and then you have to press enter. And this is for rectangle area inspection. For example, if I have drawn one rectangle, if I switch it on, it will only show the rectangle area in the colored image. Rest all will go black and white, so that you can focus on this particular rectangle. You can turn it off by clicking over here again. Highlight high temperature area is another function for your comfort. As soon as you click it, it will you can set the high temperature using this bar. For example, maybe 70 degree to 58 or whatever you want to, even if you want to go lower. So you can see whatever range you are selecting here, is highlighted over here. Other areas go to black and white so that you can focus on the high temperature areas only. And it keeps showing the spots that you have marked. Doesn't matter. So again, you can switch it off. Now let's go to some basic functions also. Like here you can select various colors, whatever you want to. Now you can adjust the colors from here also, the temperature range for different colors. Similarly, we have other colors also by default. This is the default color iron. Then you can mark your image with a text, or for example, I want to type something here. Advanced tech, you can select a font, maybe bold size, okay. And now if you want to mark it with some arrow, maybe you can also mark it using an arrow. So very simple. Now you can also rotate your images using this function. You can flip horizontally or vertically using this function. And this is for comparison between 3D and 2D. We'll come this to later. And this is resetting your image. For example, if you moved your PCB and you want to camera to refocus on your image, you can click here and the camera will refocus. Obviously, if you refocus, your existing shapes will be deleted. Now, how to delete a shape? You can always delete the shape by clicking on that shape, double clicking on that shape, and now you can see a cross is there and you can delete it. If you want to delete all, you can again reset the image. Everything will be deleted on the screen. So next, let's come to some basic settings over here. You can choose English, the language, whatever you want, English, Chinese. Then the temperature, follow the mouse. This is a very interesting feature. As you can see, wherever we are pointing our cursor at, it is showing the temperature. You can turn this off also. If it's for some reason it's not needed, you can turn it off, apply, and you can no longer see the temperature at the cursor. Now you can also set the temperature unit. Alarm sounds, alarm duration in seconds, then contrast level. These are storage picture folder, video folder, and data folder. By default, you can set a folder location. These are some camera parameters. If you want to have some higher accuracy, you can input your humidity, the temperature, the ambient temperature around you. And by using this, you can also go to default. This is for software update. So next, let's go to 3D analysis. These are the same functions in the 3D analysis also. Alarm, picture, video, shows you the peak. This is basically the color changes if you want to see, or if you want to see morphological changes. If you want to read about it, you can click here and it will take you to our tutorial manual, which, by the way, you can also view from here. You just have to click it here and you can see it opens up in the PDF viewer. So now let's come to compare. If you want to see what exactly it's showing in 3D, you can always compare with the 2D. So when you click, you have to click and hold here. Then you can see what exactly is this peak over here showing you. So this peak over here is showing you the IC. You can see by clicking on compare and then holding. This is very useful. Now, let's go to the comparison. In comparison, you can keep two PCBs. according to the camera angle, you can see like there is a division given in the picture, and you can place two PCBs on either side of the line. So now you can compare two similar PCBs and see what is wrong with one PCB as compared to a good PCB. Similarly, you can also use all these functions over here in comparison also. Now, if you go to circuit design, we have some additional functions over here, which is called analysis. So when you, for example, draw some spot, for example, I'm taking two spots right now. I'm taking one rectangle. I'm taking one line. And let's take one polygon also. I'm taking a triangle. So when you're taking all these shapes, if you want to analyze the temperature around these shapes or on these shapes, you can just click on the graphical analysis. Now you can see it's showing you 0.1, 0.2. These are spots basically. L1 is line. This is R1 is rectangle, P1 is polygon. Okay, so global temperature is basically the temperature of the whole picture, the whole PCB that is inside this picture, not outside the picture. Also, you have some various configurations you want to set here. For example, display temperature. If you want to change the displayed global temperature to average temperature, you can click here. Or highest temperature, it's up to you. Interval is basically the sampling time. So right now it's 5 per second. It is basically default. You can always change it. Then these are the things that if you for example don't want to view the rectangle, you can click here and deselect it. Then the graph will not show rectangle. But if you want to, you also have to do okay. For example, okay. So it will not show rectangle now. So for this over temperature photo, this is a very useful function. If you click here and you set temperature over here, 50 degrees, 30 degrees, whatever you want to set, then as soon as you start recording, the software will automatically take the picture of this PCB that is being viewed over here, and whenever the temperature rises above the threshold temperature you have set, it will automatically take a picture. And how to record? Let's see. So I've already set over temperature over here. I click OK. Now it shows us the graph already. The global temperature is being displayed over here. Now we start recording this. We can give it a name, or you can just save it. Now you can see it is already marking the temperature that is going above your set threshold, as you can see in the graph. Whenever the temperature is rising over the threshold, the software is automatically taking the picture. And you can, whenever you stop recording and you go to the data folder, you can see the software automatically saves it. It saves the data automatically. See, you can see all the pictures. These all pictures were taken by the software automatically. And this is the Excel file. Excel file of the graphical analysis. You can see L1 highest, P1 highest, P2 highest, maximum average temperature. It is taking all the data. So let's go back to the software now. And you can always clear the chart from this function. So similarly, it's also, this is some additional function over here. The sensor temperature, which was also being shown in the graphical analysis. So sensor temperature, basically, if you want to see some special PCB inside a box, if you want to observe the temperature on it, it can be provided, but it is an additional accessory. Inside the box, they also place a additional sensor. So that sensor temperature is displayed here for sensor temperature, yellow, or here on the screen. That's all.